In chapter 8, we have discussed the testing hypothesis about the two population means and then two population variances. Today, we are going to discuss two population proportions. Let's consider an example. Well, let's consider some election problem where is there any gender gap in the approval rating? It's a typical example. We have to compare two population proportions. Or there is a factory which has two machines. You want to compare their defective rate. Defect rate is some kind of proportion. It's a population proportion of each line, each machine. How can you test that? As you saw already, you need some kind of sample statistic. Our hypothesis look like this: whether two population proportion equal or greater than, less than, or not equal. As usual, we consider some kind of sample statistic about the P1 minus P2. It is similar to Section 8.1 to compare two population mean. As you can expect, the sample proportion difference will be the sample statistic. Do you remember these things? In case of a sample P1 here, if sample size is large, it follows normal P1 and then P1 1 minus P1 and 1. Well, in case of a P2 hat, we can write down similarly, it is a normal distribution like this. 1 minus P2 divided by N2. Well, these are random variable. The subtraction of these two random variable, the mean is P1 minus P2, the variance, but it should be positive number. Okay, that's the sample statistic. If I introduce this, well, if you understand the testing hypothesis, you are ready to do all kind of things. But if H0 is true, that means P1 minus P2 equals 0. But we don't know about the P1 and P2. How can you handle that problem? Since we don't know P1 and P2, you need to estimate that. As we did in case of testing two population means, and we used the pooled variance. Similarly, we are using some kind of pooled proportion. It's a weighted average of two sample proportion. We are using p bar. It's a weighted average. And instead of p1, p2, we just plug in here. That's the test statistic. Then we can have a formula like this. Okay? There are three kind of hypotheses, and H1 can be greater than, less than, not equal. And test statistic, P1 hat minus P2 hat, but standard error is a square root of, instead of P1, you have to use P bar. Well, this criteria is a right tail test. This is left tail test. This is two tail test. Let's consider example. It's an election problem. You collect samples. 54 out of 225 sample were he approved some candidate A. And from female population, 52 out of 175, well, they are in favor of the candidate A. You want to check there whether there is a gender difference. How can you do that? If you are using East and U, it is simple, but before we get into there, let's do it by hand. The hypothesis is P1 equal P2 and P1 not equal to P2. Therefore, you need the two-tail test. Therefore, absolute value is greater than some value. You need to calculate the sample proportion P1 had, P2 had, and then take weighted average. That is nothing but you add the whole sample, add some person who favor the candidate 8. It is overall 265. It is some kind of average of these two number, weighted average. Therefore, test statistic is 1.28. As you know, if your significance level 5%, two-tail the critical value is plus minus 1.96. It's in the middle, therefore you cannot reject H0. If you are using East and U, go to this module, you plug in this number, and you will get this one. Let's practice that. Where is this one? That's a testing hypothesis, but the two population proportion. This is default alternative hypothesis. You collect how many samples? It's 225, and then you collect 175 from female population. The calculated sample proportion was 0.24, and then this is 0.297. Then if you click execute button, they're gonna generate the normal distribution sample statistic look like this. P1 hat minus P2 hat. D is in this case 0. Okay? Therefore, using P bar, it look like this. Test statistic located here. Therefore, you cannot reject H0. It is rather simple than testing hypothesis about the population mean and variance. We are done chapter 8. In next lecture, I'm gonna discuss analysis of variance. It is extension of the chapter 8. See you on next lecture.